Hello and thanks for watching Proactive. I'm joined by Sean Browne. He's the president and CEO of Xtant Medical. Sean, very good to meet you.
Nice to meet you as well, Stephen.
So Sean, for those viewers not familiar with the company, can you tell us about Xtant Medical and what you do?
So Xtant Medical is a orthobiologics and spinal fixation company. Our primary focus, as I mentioned, is on the spine, but one of the things that you'll hear is that we've been expanding beyond just the spine, so the broader orthopedic market in general.
So what's the target market and what's the size of that potential market for you?
Sure. So our target market, again, we're primarily on the biologic side. So that domestic opportunity, because we focus almost exclusively on the domestic market, is about $2.5 billion. And it's really broken up into five categories or five different types of biologics. And we are one of the few, if the only, that serves all five markets. And that's the demineralized bone, that's the allograft markets, the stem cell market, it's the synthetic market, and it's the growth factor market. And so we are ones that compete and do very well in all five segments.
So take us through a few of the products in your pipeline that you target that market with, Sean.
Sure. So we had two new introductions over the course of the last really 12 months. One was a stem cell product, which is called OsteoVive Plus, and it's gone like gangbusters. It's actually our biggest issue, and it's a recurring issue that we've had even within our own production, is we can't make enough of it fast enough. So it's one that's gone very, very well. The second one is a growth factor product. So the growth factor product is the largest market within the broader biologics world, orthobiologics world. And so we rolled out OsteoFactor, a human-derived growth factor product that is both very, very effective as well as very safe, which is one of the bigger issues within the growth factor world. So we have two new products that are just growing like gangbusters. They were a big part of our success this past quarter, where we showed 5% year-over-year growth, but actually 12% growth in our biologics segment.
And do you see that revenue trajectory continuing upwards at this stage, Sean?
I do. And again, the biggest issue we have is, can we make enough product, right? Can we get enough made? And so given some of the challenges we've had in the AATB, which is the American Association of Tissue Banking, they want to make sure that the donors and other pieces to this are true. And so they've created some new standards. And so it is creating a little bit of a supply, or at least a donor supply issue. But we think that still this is one that's going to help us grow very nicely next year. So that's on the stem cell side. The growth factor side, there's no issues at all. That thing is run and gone. And that's actually been one that's opened up quite a few doors for us, for distributors that we typically would not be able to meet or talk with. And so this is one that's really been helping us expand our distribution footprint.
Now, you did mention in your third quarter results that you expect to reach full operating capacity in the first quarter of 2023. Will you then be able to meet this growing demand for your products?
You know, that's the hope here, right? And part of what had taken place this past year is literally a labor issue. We couldn't hire enough people. And so we've got a number of things that are taking place from us from an operation perspective. So one, we've hired up and actually hired past the number of processors we're going to need. It takes about 6 months to get an average processor up and going. But by the early first quarter, we will be fully employed. So we should be able to be fully caught up and be able to take advantage of a number of opportunities that we've had to pass on this past year. Now, some of that is getting the momentum, you know, sales is about momentum, right? And getting that back. And so I got to throw this out just universally within the tissue banking world, and that's where we are. The labor issue has been something that, you know, everybody's been suffering through. And so it's one that I think that it may become a competitive advantage for us in the fact that we have actually over-invested in that world.
Sean, you recently raised $9.75 million in a private placement. How are you going to use that to support your growth strategy?
Yes. So that's been a really seminal event within our company. You know, this company is a company that was formerly Bactrin Biologics that merged with a company called X-Spine back in 2015. And unfortunately, that was not a marriage made in heaven. And so the company had a lot of challenges. And so over the course of the last 3 years since I've been here, our team has been really rebuilding and really rebooting this company. And so this latest investment featured by Stavros Vizirgianakis, who is a successful med tech investor and med tech CEO. Sauce is really kind of a reboot and said, I want to put money behind these guys, bring in some other investors that also have deep, deep experiences, like the Inset Partners guys that hopefully will be able to help us as we grow. But you know, when Stavros and these investors saw our business, they looked at it and saw the platform for growth that we've created. And that platform for growth is one that quite frankly, you know, we've got an extraordinary footprint within our distribution network, our contracts. We got over 385 IDN contracts and every major GPO. So we really sit at a place where we can really grow and take potentially subscale companies and or capital, I'm not going to say starved, but companies that need capital, we could be there. We could literally be the platform we could be building upon. And so that's part of the four pillars that we speak about in way of how we grow our business moving forward.
Sean, the sorts of catalysts that your investors should be looking out for?
The catalysts in general, again, continued growth with our, and I'll go through the four products. You know, it's the four pillars. One, new products. Two, expand our distribution network. And that means we got 300 distributors today. There's no limit to the number of distributors we could be adding. And so there's certain parts of the country where we have been underinvested, such as the Midwest, the Mid-Atlantic, the New England areas. And so we're going to continue to focus on growing in those areas. The third big area for us is adjacent market opportunities. So we sell this biologics product and we've done very, very well in the spine world, but these same biologics products can be sold in the foot and ankle and the oncology space, in the total knee and hip spaces, the trauma spaces. So there's a number of other areas that open up to us that quite frankly, we were doing really well last year in taking advantage of some of those opportunities. Unfortunately, this year, because of our capacity constraints, we've had to dial that back a little bit. But then the biggest catalyst of all will be what we do on the M&A side. You know, we, as I look at it, you know, we're a company today that's very, very well structured to be able to add on subscaled or undercapitalized companies. And so as we look at our business and look down the path, at least from an investor's perspective, you know, being able to use our public market access to be able to help these companies get to scale and help us get to scale as well, is really what our goal is and where we plan on going.
Sean, I hope you'll keep us posted on any progress. Thank you very much for the introduction today.
Great. Stephen, it's a pleasure meeting you.
And to you. Sean Browne is the president and the CEO of Xtant Medical.